So Apple has introduced a new passwords app for iOS 18 that looks amazing and it functions so well, but I'm not going to use it. My name's Josh with All Things Secured, and I'm going to explain exactly why I don't plan to use the new passwords app from Apple, but why maybe you should. So Apple has long been storing our passwords kind of behind the scenes in the Keychain app that was hidden in the settings. So this is the first time that they've come outright with an app itself that is a dedicated app for our passwords. And when you upgrade to iOS 18, you're gonna see that app show up just automatically. Now this app seems to rival other password managers like 1Password, ProtonPass, Bitwarden, and others. And I have heard from some people that have talked about the fact that this may spell the end of these companies. Apple might be putting them out of business.
When Apple introduces a product that duplicates functionality of a third-party product and essentially puts them out of business, we call it being Sherlocked.
Now, personally, I disagree that Apple is going to Sherlock or put these other third-party apps out of business, but in order to understand why, let's go ahead and open up the Passwords app. So if you look at the Passwords app on your iPhone, you're gonna notice a couple things. First of all, it uses Face ID to open up. And if you don't have Face ID, it's going to use a backup of your, basically your login passcode. I'll talk about that in just a moment. And once you get in, you see the all passwords that you've used, which is basically all, if you've used hide my email at any point or login with Apple, that's where you're gonna find those. It's got passkeys, its own dedicated passkeys section, which is actually kind of cool. Codes, which are essentially the 2FA authenticator codes that you would get from something like Google Authenticator, Authy, or another app like that. And then Wi-Fi, which has been imported from, you know, any of the Wi-Fi that you've connected with on your Apple device over the years. So you're probably gonna see a lot of those. Now, here's the thing. Apple has done a great job of simplifying security. I think they do that so well. So instead of saying, hey, you need to go set up 2-factor authentication codes using an authenticator app on a time-based one-time code, all of that just sounds way too difficult for the average person to do. But if you call it just codes, and then you have a place where they can either manually copy and paste the code for setup or scan the QR code that's given, that makes it so much easier. And it's not hidden in some login like you'd find in a lot of other password managers, quite frankly. It's something that we're used to if you use a password manager often, but I think this makes it a lot more simple to break it out into all these different things. A passkey is its own kind of new password, and understanding that it is separate and it is new kind of makes it easier and less, I don't know, difficult to want to try to adopt. So truth be told, I think something like this could be what is needed in order to propel passkeys into this adoption by the masses where most people are using passkeys. Up until this point, it's really been kind of scary, a little bit unknown, but when you break it out like that and put it in the Passwords app, I think that's something that's going to really make people use it a lot more often. In short, Apple is taking away any excuse you might have for not using a password manager. Now, if that's you, we'll talk about that in a moment, but if you are already using a password manager, you might have already noticed a few things missing in the Apple Passwords app. Things like being able to store something other than a login. You can't go in and store your passport details, credit card info, or even a file that you want to have encrypted but accessible to you wherever you go. And if you're worried about the security of the app code itself, you might be thinking what my friends at the Surveillance Report podcast have already pointed out.
You're locking yourself into Apple's ecosystem and it's not source available and nobody can like audit the code.
Now, not being open source isn't a really big deal for me. I mean, I use and recommend 1Password, which is only partially open source, but I do know that for some people that's really, really important. Now for me, I would really miss the ability to put in other information besides just logins, such as my passport or sensitive documents, stuff like that. But more importantly, I really do not like the idea that Apple Passwords, the app, is opened by Face ID with a backup of your phone's passcode. So what I hate about this idea is that somebody looking over my shoulder and seeing the passcode that I put in there could theoretically get access to pretty much anything in my online world. Now, this is one reason that I prefer having a separate password manager app with its own master password. And I wouldn't be surprised if a little bit down the road that is a feature that changes and that Apple allows you to set a custom passcode for the Passwords app that isn't the same as your phone's login passcode. But the biggest reason reason that I won't be using the Apple Passwords app is that I don't want to be dependent on a single company for all of my security. Now, this is especially true for those who have cross-platform devices. So if you don't use all Apple devices, it's going to be a lot harder for you to use something like Apple Passwords, even though I know they have that Chrome extension and they have something for Windows users, but it's just not native to those devices, and therefore it's not going to be as easy and seamless to use. I much prefer my password vault to be separate from my operating system, and even for my 2FA passcodes or the passkeys to be separate from my password manager. This separation of powers minimizes the risk that a data hacking or a security breach of any one company would have on my entire online identity. So do you want to know my recommendation? If you are already using 1Password, ProtonPass, Bitwarden, or any other good password manager app, and I've already done a video on the ones that I recommend, then there is really no reason to make the switch over to Apple Passwords. As a matter of fact, I'd say don't do it. There are missing features, and if you've already set up your security outside of the Apple ecosystem, which I recommend, then there's really no reason to regress on that. However, if you're a dedicated Apple user, which means that all of your family's devices are Apple made, and if you don't already use a password manager, maybe you just write them down yourself or you keep strong passwords in your head, then Apple Passwords is going to be a great option to not only help you store stronger passwords, but also help you start adopting passkeys and authentication codes into your security practices. So that's my take, but if you want help setting up a third-party password manager, I have an entire tutorial that you can follow right here. And I've got a bunch of new videos coming out on passkeys, on Apple's new iOS 18, and other security topics that if you want to follow along, do so right here.